Hi everyone, welcome back to Prakasham Tutorials. In this video, I am going to discuss about one more example of the cross power spectral density. Find the cross power spectral density if first bit is Rxy of tau is equal a square by 2 sine of omega naught tau and second bit is Rxy of tau is equal a square by 2 cos of omega naught tau. Coming to the solution, first bit solution. Given that Rxy of tau is a square by 2 sine of omega naught tau. So we know that the Fourier transform of sine omega naught is j pi into del of omega plus omega naught minus del of omega minus omega naught. So using this expression, so now here in the given data, taking Fourier transform on both sides, Fourier transform of LHS term is equal to Fourier transform of RHS term. Fourier transform of Rxy of tau is Sxy of omega, a square by 2 is the constant. Fourier transform of sine omega naught tau using this basic expression, j pi into del of omega plus omega naught minus del of omega minus omega naught. So this is the first bit solution. And second bit solution, so given that Rxy of tau is a square by 2 into cos of omega naught tau. So we know that the Fourier transform of cos omega naught is pi into del of omega plus omega naught plus del of omega minus omega naught. So taking Fourier transform on both sides into given data, the Fourier transform of LHS term is equal to Fourier transform of RHS term. So Fourier transform of Rxy of tau is Sxy of omega, a square by 2 is constant. Using this basic expression, Fourier transform of cos of omega naught tau is pi into del of omega plus omega naught plus del of omega minus omega naught. And this is the graphical representation of Fourier transform of first bit graphical representation, and this is the graphical representation of the second bit. In the second bit, now here the frequency function exits plus or minus omega naught. At plus omega naught, the magnitude value is a square pi by 2, and at minus omega naught, the magnitude value is a square pi by 2. At omega is equal to minus omega naught and plus omega naught, the magnitude is a square pi by 2. Now the impulse function. Impulse function means that is represented by the straight line. At minus omega naught, this is the strength of the signal. At plus omega naught, this is the strength of the signal. And similarly, in the first bit, so this is the Sxy of omega. So now here the impulse function exit at omega is equal to minus omega naught, and the impulse function exits at plus omega naught. At minus omega naught, the strength of the signal is j a square pi by 2. At plus omega naught, the strength of the signal is here before minus is there, minus a square by 2 j pi. So this is the graphical representation of the first bit. At minus omega naught, the strength of the signal is positive, that is represented by upward direction, and plus omega naught, the strength of the signal is negative. So this is the graphical representation.